Zo, Honda Roadshow. Mooiste door Rotterdam. De 500X Honda. Let's see what it can do. Now before you start to watch this video, you need to know this is not a review. This is just a impression video, a first impression. First thing, seating position is weird. And interesting thing of the roadshow, the Honda roadshow, as it is at this location, it's free driving. No following, no group rides. So we can just see, maybe you can squeeze out one or two more. It's about 30 minutes each. I don't know, where does this go? Clutch has quite some free play, but I have the feeling there's with a lot of these test bikes that they use the normal parts just get worn down a little bit faster or something like that. I don't know, man, it just seems to happen quite a lot. It's really quiet. It can make noise, but it just doesn't. I jumped to the motor store without, you know, looking into which models they had, or into looking and reading into any of the models. I just decided to go and see what they have to offer. This is one of those models that they had for offering, and I just decided, you know what, let's take that one first. Okay, let's see. Sidewalk. Ooh, so you did feel that on the rim, which I did not anticipate. I would actually anticipate a little bit more of a, I don't know, cushioning. Maybe the tires are a little bit soft. There was a very loud horn, which I did not intend to test. I thought those were the indicators. Nice little corner. So what do we have in the dashboard? We have the gear you're in, you have the RPMs, your speed, the time, the miles, oh no, the liters per 100 kilometers estimated, total amount of kilometers on this bike, and a temperature gauge. No fuel system, so probably only a fuel light. So your indicators are in the dashboard as well. Neutral light, great beam, mist, oil check, and fuel light. So everything you need is there. And I can see everything through the tinted visor, so that's good. I like this pattern, this color scheme. It's kind of mixed between snow and sleet. Of course, the sticker front is not standard. We shall go back to that in a later moment. Let's see how it can handle some proper bumps. It does launch you from the saddle, but the bike itself stays upright. You just anticipate the bumps, they are not that hard. But it does have quite some spring load to it. It surprised me how stable this bike seems. It's quite a high bike. Only downside is that if I want to move my hands while standing up, I'm hitting the mirror. Eh? And it is very turny. It kind of reminds me like the V-Strom 600, only this one has less power. I like his brakes, man. Turning circle is a little bit bigger than anticipated, but certainly not big. This one is A2 licensed. With other words, with an A2 license here in the Netherlands. So that's the next license up. So you have one 25cc and then the next one is A2. You can ride this, but I'm not sure whether or not it's squeezed then. According to the sticker, it's just A2 licensed. So for an A2 licensed bike, it's actually quite nice. Now obviously they close these two off again, sadly enough. But I can do a little bit off-road testing here. Yeah, he doesn't like the scent. I hate it when you have to, when your foot peg is in the way of your side stand. So the Honda CB500X has a kill swift on the side stand, which is logical for an off-road bike, but something I would move. It weighs 197, woohoo, and nearly dropped it, 197 kilos. Fueled, or at least with the engine oil stuff and cooling fluid stuff and like that. 197 kilos at least drive ready, so all liquids and whatnot more, which isn't massive. This one has a 19 inch front tire, thus making off-road a little bit easier and thus creating a higher ground clearance in the center part. It's very steerable, it's very maneuverable. That's just something I like. And just by driving it for 20 minutes or so, it takes some bumps nicely. It steers very softly. Acceleration, if you're in the right gear, is quickly. It is classified as a A2, so if you're just new to bikes or you jump from 1 to 5cc into something that's a little bit more adventurous, I can see this work as a very forgiving bike. And I think this is important for beginners, to find a bike that's forgiving. I haven't ridden the old one. The old one had a 17 inch front tire, this one has a 19 inch. And from what I understood, it should improve driving qualities with a bigger front end, especially off-road. Now, I don't really have any off-road chances. I had about 10 meters or so. So I cannot really tell you much about that. This one does have semi-off-road tires, which, I mean, it always looks better with semi-off-road tires. Just get some nice 730 ones. I think the K10, for example, and the keys. And it just improves looks while still being able to handle it properly. I do like the brakes, at least the front brake. The rear one is not that strong. Both front and rear are single discs. But for some reason the rear one is not really doing much. I would prefer a little bit more feedback on my rear tire, if I'm fully honest. I need to hurry up, I need to go back. okay, bombs definitely take them standing up, or at least semi standing up, because its suspension is not great for our speed bumps. Any downsides to the bike? The big horn button. Man, that thing is absolutely massive. And I've hit it about 3 times now when I was looking for the indicators. Also probably because I'm used to be the indicators above then the horn, and it's switched around here. This is really something you get used to. The clutch, then again, that might be just bad use. That is something that you can easily replace. The mirrors are massive, so you have a good sight, but when standing up, you're there in the way. So if you're planning to do some off-road, probably get some different mirrors. I like the winch scheme so far, and I've done up to 120-ish. They're really, really good. I don't know what the top speed is. I haven't had the chance to test it. Suspension is adjustable, so you probably have to adjust it to your weight and your comfortness and your riding style. Both front and rear, by the way, so that's good. And with the sun fully in front of us, shining into my tinted visor, it becomes a little bit more harder to read the LED display. But those are details. It did come off. But that is what it does from 0 to 100. One try. Okay, thank you for watching. Can I turn it around?